In today's video, we're going to learn how to stream on Twitch Mobile, so stay tuned. Welcome to Live Streaming Tech, and if you want to learn how to stream like a pro, make sure you click that subscribe button and click that bell notification to on so you don't miss out on a single video. I have a question for you really quick, and you can leave this down in the comments below, but if you're using a mobile device, what type of content will you stream? Because I have to be honest, I have no clue when it comes to using a mobile device to stream. However, we're in luck because my brother Dale has vast knowledge in this department. Take it away, Dale.
Before I show you how to set up your Twitch stream on mobile, I think it's important that you stick around to the end, and I'm going to equip you with my live streaming toolkit. It's going to get you off to a better start. So without any further ado, let's get on into your mobile device. Go over into the App Store. You're going to download Twitch. Click open. You'll log in to your device. I'm going to keep my screen shielded here for obvious reasons. Okay, it's going to instantly open it on up. Now, to be noted, we have yet to use this over here on Twitch, so I'm just trying to start from scratch. I'm not too worried about following anything right now. All I want to do is go live. But before I do that, there's a couple things that we need to kind of go over before we just hit that live button. So in any event, we're going to select our account here. Okay, and then there's Go Live. Keep in mind, you can go into your dashboard and you can set up some of your stuff a little bit ahead of time. So let's just say, for instance, we're gonna be, chatting about live streaming on mobile. The Go Live notification is gonna be what's pushed out to your followers. In this instance, we have a whopping, I think, one or two over here on here. So I try to get creative when I'm sending out this, because if you just continue to send out the same notification over and again, your viewers are gonna be kind of become desensitized to that. So I change up and try to get it unique every single time. So it could probably be, join me for a fun time. That's probably horrible, but that'll work. I'm gonna go into the category and we're gonna be just chatting. We can probably do just chatting, we can probably do IRL, we can do creative, just based on what we're gonna be doing here. So I'm just gonna say just chatting since that's all it's gonna be. And I highly recommend take advantage of the tags, and you're gonna wanna make sure that you're exploring those tags and taking advantage of those as much as possible, because it makes you more accessible. So we're gonna go hit family friendly, we'll hit educational, and that's probably going to do it for right about now. I would say probably based on the conversation I'm going to have, we might do business. Didn't notice that. There we go. And I think we're pretty much all set at this point. We're going to hit done. So we have those tags in there. I'm going to hit save. And it's going to automatically save it over onto my channel. So if someone's visiting it right now, they'll probably end up seeing this. We can add an additional description if we wanted to, and doing a stream marker, I'm not gonna really bother with that. Let's just kind of stick with the basics. So we're gonna go on back over here. We have everything pretty much set, ready to rock and roll. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit go live. Now, I highly recommend it will get it to where your viewers aren't, you know, throwing up because it's a bad cops episode. Get yourself a good stand, a selfie stick of some sort. So I'm gonna hit go live. Okay, it's gonna ask me to enable my camera and enable my microphone. We're gonna definitely need both of those. We're gonna enable camera, I'm gonna hit okay. Enable microphone, hit okay. All right, it just goes through here. They're saying what you should probably be aware of. These are some things that are just common sense. Don't go on here being crazy, being nude. And if you happen to be one of those type of people that have a potty mouth, you may want to mark your channel as being mature content. So I'm gonna hit got it. All right. We're gonna get it all framed out. So here's what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna set up my little selfie stick and I'm gonna bring it on up here. This is the part where I can kind of describe my stream if I wanted to. So I'm gonna go ahead and tilt this down just a little bit. Ooh, that looks better. All right. So we can describe this stream. I don't know, we can say just hanging out. All right, done. And I don't think we're gonna be doing travel and outdoors. I wanna kind of probably just do just chatting. This probably should have propagated already. I'm sure it's probably been a change. And something that my brother would definitely agree with me on is if you're going live, make sure you're sharing it out. So let's share too. And we would go through and we'd select what we prefer. It could probably be Twitter, it could be Facebook. I have only got Twitter here on my mobile system here, and we can always hit copy and share it through that. But in this instance, we're not going to worry so much because it's just for example's sake. So let's go ahead and hit that start stream. I'm going to hit start stream. And it says rotate your phone to begin. All right, so we're ready to actually go. I'm going to go ahead and just tilt this up. Give me just a moment here, folks. And a voom. It switches it right into position, gives us the countdown, and now we are officially live over on the Twitch platform. This is really kind of cool. You'll notice that, you know, it's going to be full portrait. So hopefully I can be able to scrape this over from the Twitch channel and we'll drop this over into the actual video for later on. So this gives you a really good idea as to what you can do. And of course, you'll see in the right-hand corner as you're streaming, that there is a welcome to the chat room style feature. So you'll see right now that we have the chat room over here to the right hand side instead of the mobile device. So anytime someone's coming in and they're interacting with you, it's gonna pop up over inside that chat there and you'll be able to keep track of that. But in any event, this kind of gives you a good idea. If you need to, you'll probably end up clicking on the actual footage here. So let's say, for instance, I want to flip around and I want to, you know, use the other camera. I can always just hit boom, flips it on around. You can see we can go ahead and we can film the other direction. So if you happen to have a better camera versus your FaceTime camera, that's probably a good idea. So if you are done with a particular stream, you're just going to go ahead, touch the screen and hit end. End stream, are you sure? Absolutely. And of course, at that point, it should have your video available on demand. In the event that it's not, you may want to go into your settings inside your dashboard to get that all dialed in. You can see already that it has the live stream inside there. We can put clips. You can also add it into collections. I highly recommend if you had a great stream, make sure that you're exporting it or even just downloading it and saving it somewhere else, because you can always repurpose it over through other platforms, especially if you are not Twitch affiliate or partner. You can repurpose it immediately right out the gate. And if you happen to be new to live streaming, don't sweat it. Actually, I have a really good go-to resource in our live streaming toolkit. It's a really simple report and it's downloadable and for free for you when you subscribe to our newsletter at livestreamingtech.site/toolkit. But let's just say that streaming on mobile is not quite your thing. You want to go really heavy. You want to go all in. Let me show you one of the best ways to live stream today. In fact, it is my preferred way for going live versus mobile. It is the Alienware R7, and I actually did a full unboxing video that's pretty popular here on this channel. We're going to go over and take a look at that right over there. I'll see you then. CLE. Solid state drive, forgive me if I'm saying things wrong, because a lot of this stuff I had my guy kind of sort out. 2 terabytes of 7200 RPM.